Welcome to Model Building 101, where I'll cover the basic steps involved with building. Game Workshop's Primaris Chaplain on a Bike. Model making is a practice that goes back as far as recorded history. Civil engineers and architects, going as far back as ancient Rome, are known to have used models as a way to show off their ideas to those with the power to make them happen. The idea of model making had its place in the Renaissance as well. Artists, such as sculptors, have long used models of their ideas before moving on to actually creating them in their chosen material. One of the most famous artists in history was he himself a model. The man I'm speaking of is none other than Leonardo da Vinci. Among these models is that of a tank and an actual robot, centuries before either became commonplace. A company called Revell produced the first model kits for U.S. consumers in the 1930s. These early kits were made of wood and were rather flimsy and basic in design. But by the early 1950s, Revell had made the switch to plastic and the quality of the product improved and the popularity of the hobby soared, especially among young boys at the time. Today, almost all model kits are made from plastic and the detail on these kits has never been better. And the quality of these kits is a big reason why the hobby is more popular now than ever. All right, enough with the history lesson. Let's get on with building today's model. Here are the tools that I will be using to assemble our Primaris Chaplain on a Bike. The plier looking tool here is actually called a plastic side cutter. For those just starting out in the hobby, you will have to make an investment in tools. And that's the way to look at it, as an investment. The glue I'll be using is called Zap-A-Gap CA, which is a form of bonding agent. I also have two sets of files here. One is your basic 3-in-1 nail file. The metal files are what is called jeweler files. These are the basic tools you will need to build any model. Now that we've become acquainted with them, it's time to start assembling our project. Models that are made from plastic will often come with their pieces attached to this plastic frame here that is called a sprue. Each component located in the sprue are individually numbered, and by cross-referencing this number with the instructions, we learn how to assemble the model. Utilizing our plastic side cutters, we carefully clip out the components of our model in preparation for the next phase of the project, which is sanding all the pieces we've clipped out. After clipping out the components of the model, I then use the files to remove any of the excess plastic that is left on the component from clipping it out. Now that we have all the components of our model clipped out and sanded, it's time to start assembling it with the Zap-A-Gap glue. Via a method called sub-assembly, which means you sub-assemble parts of the model, prime and paint them fully, and then attaching them all together at the end to complete the model. Primers, or undercoating, as it's called by some, is usually administered via an aerosol can, as the ones shown here, from Vallejo and Citadel. However, for this project, I will be using a primer that is delivered via an airbrush. The color of the primer is black, and it is a high-gloss primer, which means it'll leave a shiny finish once it is dry. The airbrush I'll be using to apply the primer is the Badger 105 Patriot. The Patriot 105 retails for about $110 on Amazon and is hands down the best airbrush I have ever used. Well worth the $110. When applying the primer, it is important to have a nice even coat across the surface of the model. And this is best done with slow, even passes across the surface of the model while spraying. Today, all primers, whether applied via an airbrush or an aerosol can, are what are known as self-leveling primers. What this means is, as the primer dries, It'll go into all the recess areas and into the detail of the model, not obscuring it. Most primers dry in about 15 minutes to a half hour, but when using primers that have a gloss or a high shine finish like this, they're a thicker primer, which means it takes longer to dry. About 12 hours is usually a safe time to wait before moving on to the next step, which is applying the first coat of paint, also known as the base coat. One trick to see if the primer is dry is to actually look at these details and see if you can see them clearly and well defined. Once you do, then the primer is probably dry. Now that the primer is dry, it's time to begin the paint job. And the first color I'll be using is called Dark Net. I've used masking tape to cover up the tires, as we'll be painting them a different color later on. And like the primer in the previous step, you want a nice even coat across the surface of the model. This is done the same way as applying the primer. Slow even passes across the surface of the model with the airbrush. We'll do the trick every time. As we wait for the base coat to dry, it's time to move on to our next color, Thalax Gold, which we will be using to paint the head, his weapon, his chest, and a few other pieces. By now, the base coat should be dry and we are ready to begin painting the detail. The colors I have selected are Retributor Gold highlighted with Hellman's Copper. I apply the paint carefully with a small detail brush to have better control over the paint while painting these small details. Now that we have the detail on the bike finished, time to start painting the Chaplin Rider. I will be using another airbrush paint called Cool Ranch. And once our shoulder is now dry, it's time to start working on the detail, such as these devotional ribbons here, along with the trim around the outside of the shoulder and going down the arm, as well as the handlebars that the arm is attached. At this point, before attaching the arm, I have decided to put the water slide decals that came with the model on the shoulder. We're in the home stretch now, as all we have left to do is some more detail on, such as the handle of the Chaplin's weapon and his backpack. After gluing the torso onto the bike, you can see we are almost done and our Chaplin on a bike is looking pretty good, but we still have one more component to finish before we can put this bad boy in the books. Using the contrast primer called Wraithbone, I primed these books and painted them with contrast paint. In a future video, I'll explain how to use contrast paint, and as a finishing touch, I'll put on yet one more skull on top of the books. And with that, our model is complete and ready to be put on a base. Basing in and of itself is a video I plan on doing one day as well. But I hope you enjoyed my first how-to video as much as I enjoyed making it. Take care, thanks for watching.